This video is available in HD. If you're watching on YouTube, click the little HD button at the bottom of this player. If you're watching this video on my website or on my podcast, please navigate to youtube.com/effectsdude79 to watch in HD. Hey, what's up, YouTubers? Got another video tutorial for you. And today I'm going to be showing you how to install another free operating system onto your already available operating system. Doesn't matter whether it's Vista, XP, even the older versions. I'm not sure if this can be done on a Mac. You'll have to check me on that. But this will be on a PC. The things you'll need are obviously a PC. If you don't have enough space on your PC like I do, this is a 1 terabyte, external hard drive that I picked up at Micro Center for very cheap. That's great. I'm using that, has nothing on it. I usually use it for video editing, but I copied all this stuff over here so I could make this tutorial. So yeah. To get started installing, navigate to ubuntu.com. That's ubuntu.com. This is the name of the operating system we're going to be installing. It is a version of Linux, just in case you're interested. Linux is like a different operating system. An operating system is like Mac or PC. Okay, hit the download button, and then leave all these settings the same, and then navigate down to the location bar. Okay? You're going to want to open that up and find the location nearest to you. Once you've found that, hit the Begin Download button, and the ISO file for Ubuntu will begin downloading. This is a very large file, so it can take up to an hour to download. Once your file is done downloading, navigate to the place where you saved the file. You should find an ISO. Right-click on it, and use winrar to extract it. If you don't have winrar, download it to the link in the sidebar. Once winrar pops up, you can find a place that you want to download your extracted files to, and then it will start extracting it. This could take about as long as the download did. Skipping forward in time, once you've finished your download, you can navigate to the place where you saved it, and then open the folder up. Inside of it, you should find an executable file called WUBI, or W-U-B-I. Double-click on that, and you can customize your settings for installing Ubuntu. Once this dialog pops up, just fill in the blanks for whatever you want your install size to be, and your username and password for your new system. Once you're done with that, just hit install, and you're ready to go. Once the install is finished, Ubuntu will ask you to restart your system, and once you do, you will be able to select Ubuntu instead of Windows XP from the boot menu. When you do this, Ubuntu will start officially installing, and you'll be able to use your new system. Congratulations,